Welcome back, guys. Today we're going to take a look at the new XTOOL D7W. Now, this is very similar to the D7S that I looked at about a month and a half ago, or just over a month ago. Very similar. In fact, it's the same tool, except the D7S is corded between the scan tool and the vehicle, and of course this one is wireless between the scan tool and the vehicle. Now, I've actually been waiting for this tool for quite a while since I originally heard that they were coming out with this. And I actually heard about it probably 6 months ago. And I honestly wasn't sure if it was going to be real or not. And what makes this special is instead of being a Bluetooth connection between the VCI and the scan tool, or the vehicle and the scan tool, this is a Wi-Fi connection instead of Bluetooth. 99% of the other scan tools on the market, it's a Bluetooth connection between the vehicle and the scan tool. And Bluetooth is an old technology that's been updated a few times over the years, but it's still archaic and very poor in performance, slow data transfer speed, short range. It's a terrible, terrible wireless connection. I have a personal hatred towards Bluetooth. But anyway, that's what's special about this one. Let's get into it. This is the box that it comes in. This is the case that it comes in. Let's open it up. So in the case, you've got, of course, your paperwork, quick start guide, and a packing list. And of course, you've got your charging brick. And then you've got three different cords that you can plug into that charging brick, depending on what part of the world you're in. So you got three cords that will power this one charging brick. Of course, I got to keep putting labels on these because I keep getting so many charging bricks. And of course, here you've got your Wi-Fi VCI. It's got, looks like three lights on it. Looks like you've got a wireless LED. You've got a power LED and a connection LED or something along those lines. We'll find that out when we get it plugged in. And then over here, we've got the scan tool itself. Now, normally this comes packed a little nicer, but I've already been in here, and so I didn't get it packed back up the nicest. And before we go any farther, I just want to put this up on the screen so you can see it a little better. This has basically the exact same specs as the D7S from a month or so ago. If you saw that video, these are the same specs, same everything, except for, of course, the highlighted one in the middle. The communication method is Wi-Fi 2.4. Now, keep in mind, the scan tool itself, the tablet, has 2.4 and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, but that's between the tablet and the network, or between the tablet and the internet. The communication between the tablet and the VCI is 2.4. Otherwise, all the other specs are the same. If you need more time to read this, you can pause the screen now. Otherwise, we're going to continue on. Okay, so we've got the scan tool itself and the Wi-Fi VCI. We'll get this thing turned on, and you can see that it's the same physical appearance as the D7S. In fact, it's the same software, it's the same everything, except on this one, there is no data connection port for a data cable, but you still have your rubberized cover over your USB-A port. You've got your charging port and a power on and off button. And then on the back, you've got your camera with flash, and you've got your kickstand here, if I can get my, get your kickstand here. And then, of course, there's nothing else on any of the edges. That's it for ports and switches and stuff. But that's the D7W, very similar to the D7S. We're going to take this outside, and we're going to hook it up to a vehicle, and we're going to do some testing with it. We're going to try and do a system scan, and we're going to look at some live data. We're going to try and do a distance test. We're going to plug this into the vehicle, and then I'm going to get out of the vehicle and walk away from it, and I'm going to see how far away I can get while still having a good solid connection. Now, there's one disclaimer here, I must say, that just because this is capable of fast data speeds and this is capable of fast data speeds, that doesn't mean the computer in the vehicle or the computing equipment inside the scan tool is capable of that same speed. So this is only going to be as quick as the weakest link. kind of like a chain. The chain is only strong as the weakest link. Well, that's same with theoretical computer speeds. Whatever is the slowest, that's what it's going to be at. Either way, I know that this is going to be far better than Bluetooth. And in fact, in my opinion, don't want to get too far out in the weeds here, but in my opinion, all other scan tools now are going to be scrambling to try and come up with their own Wi-Fi versions. The only other Wi-Fi VCIs that I know of come with scan tools that are $3,000, $4,000, or $5,000. I think probably the cheapest one with Wi-Fi that I know of is $3,000. So to get one in this price range, in my mind, is a really big deal. So you watch. You heard it here first. Everybody else in the scan tool world is going to be scrambling to come up with their own Wi-Fi VCIs now. That'll be the next new thing. And XTOOL did it first. Let's take it outside and get it hooked up to a vehicle. All right, so it's a day or two later, and we're sitting out in the vehicle now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to park this thing in the street, and then I know how far it is from the street all the way past my garage into my backyard where my shed is, and we're going to do a distance test. But before we do that, real quick, I posted a community post on the YouTube channel about this new Wi-Fi tool, and I had a legitimate question, and I can see where there'd be some confusion. The question was, what do you do when there's no Wi-Fi service? Well, I could see where that would be a little bit confusing. Normally, you connect one device to a Wi-Fi network, and then you connect the other device to a Wi-Fi network, and then through the wireless router, the two devices can talk to each other. Well, this is a little bit different. This would be Wi-Fi direct between the scan tool tablet and the VCI. This does not need any extra networking equipment. That does not require a wireless router or an existing Wi-Fi network to put both devices onto. They work directly with each other. So no existing Wi-Fi needed to make these work. Just wanted to get that, just wanted to be clear on that so there's no confusion. All right, so we're gonna park this thing in the street, and you'll see I'm gonna walk back past my shed and past my, into my backyard, and at the front of my shed, it's gonna be 95 feet from the curb, and the car will be in the street. And then to the back of my shed, it'll be about 107 feet to the curb. Let's see if this new Wi-Fi VCI can make it that far. Oh, no. As you can see, there's the car out in the street. I'm standing next to the shed. We're about 97 feet away from the car. Here's the scan tool right here. I'll switch over to the screen recorder. We'll get connected here. We'll do auto scan. Sorry for the wind, if you can hear any wind. It's a pretty windy day out. It's time to do leaves. Getting connected to the vehicle. Automatic scan. It's got one engine code in that vehicle. As you can see in the upper right-hand corner where it says VCI, there's a green Wi-Fi signal showing we got good signal, and we're, like I said, we're about 97 feet from the car. Let's go back. Now I'm going back to the back of my shed. So we're about 107 to 108 feet away from the car right now. We're still scanning, no problem. Probably about 117 feet from the car right here. Still scanning, still connected. There's about 127 feet from the vehicle. Still connected, still scanning. Go back even farther. About 137 feet from the vehicle, 140 feet from the vehicle, and I'm at the back fence of my property. Can't go any farther. Still connected, still scanning. That's pretty impressive. We'll move back forward here. About 140 feet, and it was still scanning. That's pretty impressive. All right, well, that concludes our distance test on the new D7W. If you guys are in the market for a new scan tool, these are definitely worth checking out. And like I said, this is the first one with a Wi-Fi VCI. Other than the super high-end tools, you just saw it here, about 140 feet from the car to the scan tool, and we were still at a rock-solid connection. Now, there is a disclaimer there. You know, that was line of sight. You know, if you put a few walls in the way, you may have a little bit shorter distance, but, you know, 140 feet, that's pretty darn good. So, anyway, that's all I have for now. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.